I will show you how to dress an electrical distribution board, including how to install MCBs and other components. We will provide you with complete information, so let's get started with the video. Right now, we have two rooms, which include a kitchen, a bathroom, and a hall. These are all the wires for the setup. We are going to arrange them so that the MCB looks neat and all the wires are well organized. We will show you the entire process step by step. First, we will separate the red, black, and green wires. These are the red wires. We will move them to the back and start setting them up. These wires will go into the breakers, so we will arrange them accordingly. Similarly, we will separate the black wires, as this is where our common point is located. After that, we will separate the green wires as well. Then, this additional red wire will also be separated and grouped with the first set of red wires. Finally, we will secure all of them with cable ties. Now, you can see that I have arranged all the wires and secured them with cable ties. The black wires have also been cut to the appropriate size. These wires here are our main line wires. After that, there are two special wires used for motor operation. Additionally, you can see the green wires. They have also been properly arranged. Now, all the black wires have been connected to their respective common points. These two wires are for the motor. You can see they have been separated, while the rest of the black wires have been attached to the common point. Now that all the wires are connected, it's time to install the MCBs. They are attached to the brackets. As you can see, one column of breakers has been installed, with five breakers in this column, and the remaining breakers will be installed below it. Now, all the wires will be connected to the breakers one by one, arranging them properly as we go, and we will show you the process step by step. To install a wire into a breaker, first measure the required length of the wire, then cut it accordingly. After cutting, use a wire stripper to strip the insulation off the wire. Then, insert the wire into the breaker and tighten it securely using a screwdriver. Make sure to tighten it properly to avoid any issues with loose connections. Now, you can see that the first column of breakers is complete and all the connections have been made. Everything is properly arranged and it looks neat and organized. Now it's time for the second column, which also contains five breakers. You can see that the wires for the lower column have also been attached and have been properly tightened to ensure there are no loose connections. Now we will install the 63-amp main breaker, which is a double pole breaker. We will securely place it on its bracket and lock it properly. Along with it, we will install two additional MCBs purely for aesthetics, so the board looks well organized. However, if needed in the future, we can also use these extra breakers. Now we have the changeover switch, or you can call it the main switch, along with the indication lights and the voltmeter, which will help us monitor the voltage supply. Let's go ahead and install these in their respective places. We will also make sure to connect the power supply properly to avoid any loose connections. And here is the final look. Now we have reopened the changeover switch, and we will show you the connections of the main breaker, which is the 63-amp double pole breaker. Here, you can see how we have taken the output from the double pole MCB to supply both columns. Both columns are receiving power from the main supply, as you can see. Additionally, the neutral output has been taken from the main MCB and connected to the common point, which we showed you earlier. Additionally, you can see that the main supply has been connected to the upper side of the double pole MCB. Most breakers have the option to create the main supply either from the upper side or the lower side. You can choose this based on your convenience. Now, the remaining task is to provide the main supply connections to the upper MCBs as well as the lower ones. For this, we will install a busbar comb, and I'll show you how it looks. Alternatively, you can also use jumper wires for this purpose. This is the busbar wire comb, and you can cut it according to your needs since it comes in long sizes. We need it in segments of 5, so we will cut it accordingly. You can see that I have already installed the busbar wire in the upper column, while the lower column is still pending. Similarly, we will cut another piece of 5 and install it. Now here is the final look of the distribution board, as you can see. Click on the left or right thumbnail to watch our next videos, and subscribe. Thank you.